Hey everyone, so let's say you want to stay in the Christmas Story house, and oh darn, it's booked. Well, guess what? You can come right next door to the Bumpus House. That's the brainchild of Brian Jones. First of all, brainchild of buying the Christmas Story house. Now, seven lots.
Seven lots. You know,
and how many buildings?
Four.
And this is the fourth.
And
you still have all your hair?
I have all the hair. It's getting a little grayer, a little bit coming under the beard.
When I first met you, you were on clean shaven. Now there's gray in the beard. But that's totally cool. You've done a lot for the area. So, big idea when you said, when you started renting the Christmas, or people can stay and spend the night.
Yes.
Huge surge in popularity. So that kind of was a brainchild to have you come over here and buy the Bumpus House, right?
Yeah, and it just, it's obviously need more capacity, more people interested. You know, it makes it something more fun that we can add to the experience.
Now we're on the second floor now, so same feel that we went for downstairs.
Yes. Okay. So kind of that 1940s, 50s kind of eclectic, you know, keeping some stuff together, you know, just to give it kind of a cool, something you don't always see and not could be able to stay at, so.
And you're a very smart young man, but you knew you were out of your, you were out of your element trying to design this.
Yes.
So you hired a professional interior designer, correct?
Yes, Jennifer Hoffine did all the interior design here. We went over stuff. She would find stuff like on Craigslist and on Facebook and find different things and then just reupholster them. She picked all the wallpaper. This is her, you know, brainchild here to redo this piece of furniture into a sink with a farmhouse top, and pick all the fixtures and then the kind of the fun backsplash tile.
Yeah,
so just making it kind of cool and different. And they got the little stand for the microwave.
How many people all in can stay here overnight?
So we have two suites, so you could do 10 total people, or you can do 4 on the bottom, 6 on top. So two places to stay in here.
Yeah, awesome. Well, Jimmy, take a tour of the bedrooms. And Jane, your mom owned the place, so this is really cool. And as a young 18, 19-year-old, you actually stayed in the house?
Overnight.
So how much has it changed since you were 18 or 19? I mean, you said there were 5 bedrooms up here.
One time there was 5 bedrooms. They knocked one out to make one big one, and actually I think we're standing in it right now. I can't even tell
right.
Tell you the truth.
It looks so different.
The house is amazing, what Brian's done to it.
And very cool, because you know, and this is a really a way to kind of for you to maybe preserve your mom's memory, you know?
She'll always be here. Her legacy, I mean, my mom would love this. She'd be proud.
Yeah, of what Brian and his family have done.
Yeah.
Now, big question, are you gonna spend the night here one night?
Actually, I am. actually, we're gonna have a girls' night here.
Ah!
All the nieces and sister, and actually this month. So it's gonna be a lot of fun.
Well, Jane, thanks for working with Brian on this, because this is a really cool labor of love for you both. It's so awesome.
Yes.
And your husband approved, so that's always a plus.
Yes, he
But he's not invited to girls' night.
Nope.
No. All right, we're at the Bumpus House, right next door to the Christmas Story House. As you can see, Brian Jones and his team did a great job.
So, Wayne said,
16
is that a
people
big screen
on
the TV.
He just
yeah,
now
it is
said,
a big screen
the
TV.
Got a
yes.
big screen TV.
Yes.
So,
the modern amenity.
Are you in for the sleepover then?
Well, as long as it got the big screen, we're the only ones in 1950 to have a big screen TV. That's good
funny.
Stuff.